My son had a brain tumor when he was 11. When they took it out, it left him paralyzed from the neck down. They said he would be in remedial classes the rest of his life.
In fact, her son David Jr. was told he would never walk again, but his mom and dad were determined to find a way.
It was a need for him to walk again and live life again.
When insurance wouldn't pay for hyperbaric oxygen therapy, they turned to this. Scuba diving mimics the effects of hyperbaric oxygen therapy, which studies have shown reduces inflammation and restores blood flow to the spinal cord.
Couldn't move anything. Where I am now, I walk, I run, I dive.
Within a year, David Jr., still technically paralyzed, was walking. That's when David and Kimberly knew they needed to help others.
I can't stand up without falling over.
Diagnosed with a neurological disorder, Craig Doris hasn't walked in 8 years. But under 12 feet of water, he can walk.
I think coming here is keeping me in touch with the bottom of my feet.
I had an issue with my legs, yes, where muscle refused to develop. This definitely helped get my muscle going.
Scuba therapy allows people to increase strength and flexibility in a weightless environment. It's also proven to help people with mental and developmental disorders like Benjamin do what he likes most.
Lifting some weights and throwing the watermelon balls.
Benjamin is able to find something underwater that he can't anywhere else.
Everything slows down for
him. With the autism, it generally lowers anxieties. It helps them focus better, and they sleep better. However, it has a residual effect. So it lasts usually about 7 to 10 days.
With more than 100 diving volunteers, the scuba gym has helped thousands of people with special needs with locations in Florida, North Carolina, and Sydney, Australia. And they hope to keep expanding.
It changes my life. Down there on the bottom, I can stand up, walk around, bend over, pick something up. It's the most euphoric feeling in the world.
I'm Nancy Alvarez reporting.